Hi, I'm Sergio Guerrero and I'm here to talk about Ralph's design. First, I will name the terms we use in this film, and then I will enumerate the steps you must follow to reach Ralph's design, as I explain a real example of Ford Motor Company. So, we could say that we're going to talk about a method for designing and conducting experiments to improve the performance of noise, even in the presence of uncontrollable variations. And we can distinguish between four terms in this field: Ralph's product, noise, Ralph's design, and Ralph's set point. We can define a Ralph's product as one that performs as intended, even under non-ideal conditions, such as manufacturing process variations. We use the term noise to describe uncontrollable variations that may affect performance, and we say that a quality product should be robust to noise factors. Robust design is the product development activity of improving the performance of products while minimizing the effects of noise. In robust design, we use experiments and data analysis to identify robust set points. These are a combination of design parameter values for which the product performance is as desired, even under variations. The approach to robust design that we're going to talk about is based on a method called DOE, or design of experiments. In this method, the team that is working on a robust design must identify which parameters can be controlled, which noise factors they want to investigate, and then designs, conducts, and analyze experiments to achieve the robust performance. To develop a robust a product through DOE, you should follow these 7 steps process. Step 1. Identify control factors, noise factors, and performance metrics. Step 2. Formulate an objective function. Step 3. Develop the experimental plan. Step 4. Run the experiment. Step 5. Conduct the analysis. Step 6. Select and confirm the factor set points. And finally, step 7, reflect and repeat. These are the steps that Ford Motor Company followed when they wanted to investigate the performance of rear seat belts, because they wanted to avoid the phenomenon called submarining that results in abdominal injuries. So, let's begin. Step 1. Identify control factors, noise factors, and performance metrics. Control factors are design variables that can be varied in a controlled manner during the experiment. Noise factors are variables that can be varied during manufacturing and operations of the product. And performance metrics are product specifications of interest in the experiment. After listing several factors, the team must decide which ones they want to investigate. In the case of Ford Motor Company, they chose 7 control factors, 3 noise factors, and decide to use the back angle at peak as the output metric. So let's move on to the step 2. Step 2, formulate an objective function. The performance metrics must be transformed into objective functions. They can be formulated as functions to be maximized or minimized. The Ford statistician suggested 2 objective functions: the average back angle at peak and the range of the back angle at peak, both functions to be minimized, because back angle at peak is better metric. Step 3. develop the experimental plan. Here you have to organize and find a proper combination of trials to investigate all the noise factors and control factors you have chosen so that the experiment fits your budget. In this example, the 14 made a combination of the made two combinations of the three noise factors they have chosen, and this resulted in 16 experimental runs. Step 4, run the experiment. In this example, in the seatbelt experiment, they run the experiment and wrote down the data obtained. So then they calculated the average and the range values. Step 5, conduct analysis. Put the data into graphs and study which factors can be used to minimize the main performance. For example, in the average back angle at peak, the factor levels that must be used to reduce this metric should be the ones that are in red. So, next step. Step 6. Select and confirm factor set points. In this step, you have to determine which factors have a strong effect on the main performance and check if the robust performance have been achieved. And that's what 14 did. By choosing the blue ones, the factors in blue, to increase the robustness, and the red ones to increase the performance. And finally, we have step 7, reflect and repeat. One round of experiments may be sufficient, but if you want to optimize the results, additional rounds may be required. So if you do additional rounds, you should reconsider the set points, explore interactions among some of the factors, and investigate other control factors and noise factors. So to conclude, remember that first, you have to identify the control factors and noise factors you want to investigate to solve the problem you have found. Then organize the experiment in several runs. Then, next, run the experiment and write down the data obtained. And finally, analyze the data and check if the robust design has been achieved. I hope you liked the video. If you have any questions, please write them down on the comments, and thank you very much. Bye.